Okay, just talking you through this week topic assessment. The first one, 2 times your P plus your Q. That's it. Next one, it's A times your P. I'll just put this in here. So it's A times your P plus B times your Q equals 1, 0. Just do the I's, the top line, and do the J's, the bottom line, and then just solve them simultaneously. Okay, number two. The points, if you got, they give you coordinates. Write them as position vectors, not to A, not to B, not to C, as columns. Then A to B, hopefully you're okay going through 0. A to C, go through your 0, and B to C, go through 0. So hopefully that's okay. Just make sure, you know, when you're going backwards, you reverse the signs of each number. So I should use Pythagoras' theorem for the lengths of that. And then a unit vector of AB. See, the length of AB, where's AB? Up here, 1 squared or 3 squared. And the unit vector is 1 over its length times the vector itself. Number 3. Let me see. Write them as position vectors, first of all. And then you are told S to R equals P to Q. Right, you've got plenty of points over here that you can work with this. P to Q is P to O plus O to Q. P to O, do it backwards, minus 1, add 4. There's O to Q going forward, so you've got S to R. Okay, then the next thing, find the coordinates of S. So basically I need to find the position vector of S. So let's look at this. O to S plus S to R. If you look, the S's match up. That's the same as O to R. O to S, I don't know, I'm trying to find. S to R, you've just worked out. O to R, you know. Bring that over, take it away. You've got O to S. And then part 2, what shape? It's a parallelogram. You sort of draw that out there. Helps you see it. M is the midpoint of PR. So P to M is half of P to R. Because it's the midpoint. P to R you can work out. Then we have Q to M. So Q to M, if I go back up to my wee diagram here, it might help you sort of picture what's going on there. P to R and M is the midpoint. Find Q to M. So if you look there, I go Q to P plus P to M. So it's under my fingers. Q to P plus P to M. I don't have Q to P yet, so that's me working out Q to P. So Q to O plus O to P. See the way? Q to P. So work that out and then add on the PM at the end. Hopefully giving you that. And number 4. 3 forces, the resultant. Resultant's a total. So that's me adding them. And it acts in the direction of 2i add j. Right, this is tricky. If you add up all your forces, it acts in this direction. So it could be a 10-5. It could be a 20-10. It could be a 1.5. It could be some factor of this. But that's the direction it is. I don't know exactly how far out it goes, but that's just the direction. So what I'm going to do, if you look here, look at the i's. They've been divided by 5, or going this way, times by 5. So if I times this by 5 to get my j's, I will then have the 2 add a equals 5. You see what's happened? Look, this one's been divided by 5, so times by 5 to go back, just to match this up. You then work out that your a is going to be a 3. Okay, then you can work out the resultant 10, and that's a 5. And then the magnitude is your Pythagoras theorem.